Transformers are everywhere, from your phone charger to the grid powering your home. But their evolution wasn't obvious. In fact, early designs wasted more energy than they delivered. Today, we'll explain how transformers work in a simple way and explore the early design flaws that shaped modern power systems. Welcome to Electrical Lad, where we break down electrical and control systems in a way that just makes sense. If you're new here and love hands-on learning, consider subscribing. Always remember, electricity can be dangerous. You should be properly trained or supervised before working with any electrical circuits. The transformer emerged in the late 1800s, right in the middle of the battle to bring electricity to the world. Inventors like Goddard, Gibbs, and later Tesla and Westinghouse explored coil arrangements and magnetic materials. One of the earliest transformer designs used a straight piece of iron, or even a steel bolt, with wire wrapped around it. It's similar to what you'd get if you tried wrapping a copper coil around a metal bolt to pass current. The result? It looked like it worked, but it got hot, fast, and that heat meant wasted energy. A transformer takes electricity at one voltage and delivers it at another. But the way it works might surprise you. When alternating current flows through the primary coil, it creates a changing magnetic field. This magnetic field doesn't just float around. It's directed by an iron core, like a path guiding invisible energy. The field moves through the core and reaches the secondary coil. As the magnetic field constantly reverses direction, because of the 60 Hz AC, it induces voltage in the secondary coil. The number of turns in each coil decides how much that voltage changes. More turns in the secondary means higher output voltage. Fewer turns means lower voltage. This relationship is called the turns ratio, and it's written as V over V2 equals N over N2. So, if the secondary coil has twice as many turns as the primary, the output voltage doubles. But this only works well if the magnetic field is efficiently transferred. And that's why the shape and material of the core are so important. Now, here's something important. The current moves in the opposite way. When voltage goes up, current goes down. And when voltage goes down, current goes up. That's because a transformer doesn't make power, it only transfers it. In fact, in an ideal transformer, the power going in is the same as the power coming out. So if the voltage is doubled, the current is cut in half. This is why the current ratio flips the turns ratio. It follows this rule, I1 over I2 equals N2 over N1. So how does this apply to the real world? Electricity from power plants starts at a lower voltage, but before it travels long distances, it's passed through a step-up transformer, raising the voltage dramatically. Why? Because higher voltage means lower current for the same power, and lower current means less heat loss in the wires. Then, at a substation closer to your neighborhood, the voltage is stepped down. Finally, a drum-shaped transformer, usually mounted on a pole or placed on the ground, reduces it again to a safe level before it enters your home. Today's transformers don't use a solid metal bolt. They use laminated steel cores, thin sheets of iron stacked together with very thin insulation in between. Why? Because of eddy currents. So what are eddy currents? I will explain that next. Early transformer designs used solid iron rods as the core, which seemed like a simple solution. But according to Faraday's law, any change in magnetic field induces a current, not just in the coils, but also inside the metal core itself. These swirling currents are called eddy currents, and they waste energy by turning it into heat. This is why engineers use laminated cores, made of thin, insulated layers of metal. These layers disrupt the formation of eddy currents, like speed bumps for electricity. The thinner the layers, the harder it is for large currents to form, and the more efficient the transformer becomes. But eddy currents aren't the only issue. Another type of core loss is hysteresis loss. It happens when the magnetic field inside the core changes direction as the AC current switches back and forth. The material inside the core doesn't respond instantly. It resists these changes slightly, and that resistance turns some energy into heat. It's like bending a paperclip over and over. It heats up from the effort. Using materials like silicon steel makes it easier for the magnetic field to change, reducing heat and improving efficiency. Transformers only work with alternating current, AC, because it's the continuous change in direction that creates a changing magnetic field. And it's this changing field that induces voltage in the secondary coil. With direct current, or DC, the magnetic field is steady. You'll get a brief pulse when it's first switched on, but after that, no voltage is induced. That's why transformers rely on AC, and why AC became the backbone of long-distance power transmission. From miniature phone chargers to high-voltage transformers on utility poles, all use the same principle: two coils and a magnetic core. But the materials, insulation, and core shape are engineered to minimize losses and maximize efficiency. Even current and potential transformers used in measurement work on these same fundamentals. Now you should understand how transformers work and how their design has evolved to minimize energy loss and guide magnetic fields efficiently. If you found this helpful, hit like, share it with others, and subscribe to Electrical Lad for more simplified engineering insights.